I'm going to make a bet. We're recording on Wednesday, so the 60 Minutes interview isn't coming out for a few days yet, unless Trump drops it on YouTube. But I'm going to go ahead and make a prediction about the video I haven't seen anyway. So just in case you hadn't heard, Trump made a bunch of headlines on Tuesday when he apparently stormed out of an interview with CBS's Leslie Stahl. 60 Minutes is doing an episode that includes interviews with both candidates and their running mates. Or at least that was the plan. Trump got pissy halfway through the interview and walked out, then refused to come back for a segment he was supposed to film with Mike Pence afterwards. Now, there have been a couple of reports where unnamed sources characterized the interview as bad, but not unusually bad. Nobody specified what question or line of questioning set him off. But the White House has confirmed he bailed on the interview, and Trump went on a bitchy little tweet storm about Leslie Stahl afterwards. Then he whined about her during a rally later. So here's my prediction. I'm guessing Leslie Stahl was no harder on him than Chris Wallace was on Fox News or Jonathan Swan was for Axios. I'm guessing the misogynist just can't handle that same treatment at the hands of a gender he considers inferior to his own. And I'm also guessing that's going to make for a damn interesting dynamic in tonight's debate. And let's not make the mistake of thinking this is a Trump thing. This is a GOP thing, and they've been cultivating it for decades. I think any honest person can admit that sexism is a big part of the reason Trump was elected. But it wasn't just sexism against Hillary. A lot of misogynists liked having a candidate that was openly hostile to women and women's rights. A candidate who wasn't going to play along with the idea that women had an equal say. The GOP have been planting seeds of misogyny beneath their platform since the 80s and the first rumblings of the moral majority. So it should surprise exactly nobody when they harvest rampant sexism. And we were reminded of that yet again when Oklahoma Senator James Lankford went on a Christian podcast called On the Edge and started spouting off about how if God had his druthers, the U.S. government would be entirely populated by Christian men. And no, he wasn't just using men as a stand-in for humanity, unless he got way more progressive about lesbian marriage since the last time I saw him, because he refers specifically about how the government needs godly men who love their wives. And let's face it, even if that was the case, he'd still be excusing the discrimination against one group by pointing out that he meant to discriminate against a different group. And again, that's not the case. He literally intended to discriminate against both. Also, quick before I wrap things up, I want to remind you that as hard as it is to follow any single thread through today's news cycle, we're still on the verge of cementing a conservative, anti-woman, theocratic majority on the Supreme Court for the rest of my life. So, you know, vote like it. And with that reminder echoing in your ears, I'll hand things back over to Noah, Heath, and Eli.